Hello, it's my Eurovision 2021 Top 39 Countdown, place number 14, it's Malta Destiny, Junior Casse. Welcome to Matt Loves Eurovision. Please do click the subscribe button, ring that notification bell, and like, share, and comment below. So we've reached the point of my countdown where we have the current betting favourite, at the time of this recording anyway, and before the rehearsals start. So yes, Malta are top of the bookies, the betting odds at the moment, and actually have been there really probably very soon after the song was released in March, so it's held that position for a long period, and that's really quite great news, because so often when you come to the betting odds you always kind of see the usual suspects, the big powers of Eurovision, Sweden, Italy, Russia, etc. So it's great to see Malta up there as top in the betting odds. Malta have got a really illustrious history, really, for such a tiny country at Eurovision. They're so passionate about Eurovision, they really love it. And also they've come so close on a number of occasions. So I think to have them at the top of the betting odds is great. They've also been in Eurovision, I think, aside from Cyprus, longer than anyone else without a win yet, so it feels like they are really overdue. So all of that is great, great news to hear. And in the shape of Destiny, who is their artist, they have a real superstar. She is a winner of Junior Eurovision back in 2015, but she has sort of grown over the years in confidence, assurance, and such an amazing vocal. She has such an amazing voice. Now, her full name, Destiny Chukunyere, she's still only 18, but obviously she has been known to the Eurovision fandom for quite a lot longer than that, having won Junior Eurovision back in 2015. And it's always felt like a question of the when rather than if Destiny would eventually represent Malta at Eurovision. Now, she's appeared at various Eurovision events, but she was actually also on the main Eurovision stage, albeit hidden, when she was a backing singer for Michaela Pace in 2019 for Malta. But she won the Maltese X Factor in early 2020, which gave her the right to be the Maltese Eurovision entry for 2020. Now, quite wisely, they decided not to go through a reselection process for 2021 and internally selected Destiny for this year's entry. Now, it's quite similar. It's quite different, I should say. It's quite a different song from her song in 2020. So, All My Love, which was her song last year, was kind of a mid-up-tempo, kind of R&B soul, sort of pop song. Junior Casse is quite different. It's sassier, it's kind of quite bold, very empowering and confident in the lyrics. And she comes across really confidently in it. Personally, I think her song last year showcased her vocal, her amazing voice, and perhaps a little bit more than the Eurovision version of Junior Casse. But I know she's done some really amazing kind of live orchestral and acoustic versions of this. And what also makes this stand out is the kind of instrumental drop. It's a very 1920s sounding sort of instrumental drop, which is really catchy and will be very memorable. And actually you can well imagine it being used on Eurovision videos in the future, when they do the kind of mini background videos they do. So particularly they use the music of the winner or one of the main songs, and you just can see it fitting in so well there. In terms of of how it will do, obviously it is the betting favourite at the moment, and indeed from what I've seen in kind of where we are with the OGA poll at the moment, as well as other kind of fan or jury polls that have been going on, it's coming up very high, if not top, in almost all of them. So I think that really stands as a good set. I don't think we've got any worries about it qualifying. What's been a bit of a problem for Malta in recent years is that they get a decent jury vote, but the televote has let them down, 2019 being a particular case in point. But there have been other years as well. Now, I think Well, I do think with this sort of song, it will get the jury votes. I'm hoping that it will do well, you know, respectably with the televotes, but it deserves to do respectably with the televotes. And it's going to be interesting to see whether or not that will, how far that will push it up. Will it carry it over the line for Malta's first win? I think whatever happens, I think Destiny is destined to have a good future anyway. She's been signed up for Sony Worldwide. She's got a contract with Sony Worldwide that was announced quite recently. So I think whatever happens, her future will be bright.